Hello everybody, it's nice to see you all today. My name is Louise and I am going to be reading you a story. I wonder if sometimes you find it hard to do the right thing. In today's story, we meet someone who is told he can't pray to God. But this person carries on praying to God because he believes it's the right thing to do. As you listen to this story, you will see that God's people are no longer living in their own land. They're living far away from home. So, let's open the book at the story of Daniel and the lions. Daniel missed his home in Jerusalem, but he wanted to please God wherever he was. So he worked hard at his jobs and did everything that he was told. So hard that he became one of the king's own helpers. But he never forgot about God or failed to pray, morning, noon or night. Some of the king's men were jealous of Daniel. They wanted his job for themselves. So they talked the king into making a new law. A law which said nobody, absolutely no one, was allowed to pray to anybody except the king himself. Oh, we've got Daniel now, laughed Daniel's enemies. And so they had. The next morning, Daniel knelt by his window and bowed his head and prayed. And not to the king, but to God. Thank you for taking care of us in this faraway land, he prayed. Forgive us and please take us back to our own land soon. Daniel's enemies were watching. And before he could even open his eyes, they dragged him back in front of the king. The king was very sad. He liked Daniel. He could not break his own law, though. Oh, Daniel must be punished, he thought. Throw him in the lion pit. But even as the king gave the order, he whispered a prayer that nobody else could hear. A prayer to Daniel's God. Daniel may be saved. The pit was dark. The pit was deep. And the floor was covered with lions, like a shaggy, growling carpet. Can you all growl like lions for me? Roar! That's right. The lions leapt to their feet as soon as Daniel landed amongst them. They licked their lips. They showed their teeth and their eyes shone fierce and bright. They opened their mouths and moved towards their dinner. And then they stopped. Shoo, 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 scat, go away, shouted a voice right behind Daniel. The lion's mouths snapped shut. Can you do that? Snap. Their tails drooped. They whimpered away to a corner of the cave. Slowly, Daniel turned around and looked at the face of a huge angel. Nothing to worry about now, the angel smiled. God sent me to watch over you. Why don't you have a sleep? The next morning, the king cheered when he discovered that Daniel was still alive. Can you all cheer and clap your hands for me? Daniel's alive, cheered the king. Pull Daniel out, he ordered his men. And while you're at it, take the men that talked me into making that silly law and dump them into the pit instead. The king put his arm around Daniel and walked him back to the palace. Meanwhile, Daniel's enemies cried for help and the lions enjoyed their breakfast. Daniel knew it was wrong to pray to the king and right to pray to God. He risked being eaten by the lions, but he still chose to do what he knew was right. He honoured God and God took care of him. Doing the right thing can be difficult sometimes. Daniel was very brave, wasn't he? As we close our eyes, see if you can think of a time when you were brave. You ready? Close your eyes and think of a time when you were brave. going to say a prayer, and if you want to make it your prayer, say Amen at the end after me. Dear God, sometimes other people try to make us do the wrong thing. Please help us to be brave and stand up for what we know is right. Amen. Well, thank you, everybody. I really enjoyed that story. So I'll see you next time. Bye.